We'll now consider the next legislation, H.R. 1365, the Guam War Claims, sponsored by Mr. San Nicolas of Guam. Without objection, the bill will be considered as read and open to amendment at any point. Let me recognize the sponsor of the legislation, Mr. San Nicolas, for any for comments on his legislation. Sir?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would like to begin by thanking the Committee Vice Chair of Insular Affairs, Congressman Sablon, for enabling this markup hearing, as this is an insular issue. I would like to thank you, Mr. Chair, and the full committee for bringing 1365 to markup today as a technical correction for a time-sensitive matter. I would like to thank my colleagues on the committee for their support and openness in taking our meetings, receiving our calls, and answering their questions on the issue at hand. I would like to thank my predecessors for their work that laid much groundwork over many years to bring us to this inflection point today. I would like to thank my local leadership counterparts in my district, particularly Speaker Barnes, for her letters of support, as well as the Republican Party of Guam for endorsing the passage of H.R. 1365 as a bipartisan issue. And at this time, Mr. Chairman, I would like to seek unanimous consent to enter into the record a resolution passed by the 35th Guam Legislature, Resolution 36-35, endorsing the passage of H.R. 1365 without any objections.
So ordered.
I would also like to enter into the record, Mr. Chairman, four letters from our Speaker of the Guam Legislature dated June 17th, also seeking support for H.R. 1365 without objections.
This, right. So ordered.
I would also like to enter the record, Mr. Chairman, a letter from the Republican Caucus of Guam dated June 18th, also supporting 1365.
So ordered.
And I would also like to seek unanimous consent, Mr. Chairman, for a letter dated June 6th from the Guam Republican National Committee, also endorsing the passage of H.R. 1365.
So ordered.
I would like to go on to further thank the senior citizens of Guam that H.R. 1365 intends to remedy for their courage and sacrifice that has earned them the title of the greatest generation on Guam. And at this time, I'd like to enter into the record a Guam Pacific Daily News article dated May 7th, 2019 that features Mrs. Irene Scambaluri, a war survivor who shares her experience without objections.
So ordered.
I would like to thank the servicemen and their families who gave their lives many, many years ago to make days like today possible. And most of all, I would like to thank our Lord for His Majesty that has ensured that a people literally on the edge of this country have never been forgotten by the greatest nation on earth. Mr. Chairman, that remembrance was powerfully captured 75 years ago when American troops reclaimed Guam from Japanese occupation during World War II. This occupation resulted in over 3 years of brutality for the people of Guam, who endured forced marches, forced labor, rapes, beheadings, and countless other atrocities at the hands of foreign occupiers at war with the United States. Since this time, the impacted people have on multiple occasions sought redress for these sufferings and have petitioned the United States as it absolved Japan at the conclusion of the war and as a gracious victor assumed responsibility for post-war peace. To date, our country has acknowledged these petitions with the statutory adoption of a claims process and funding commitments with the Guam World War II Loyalty Recognition Act, most recently adopted in the language contained in the 2017 National Defense Authorization Act. Unfortunately, such language contained provisional flaws that prevent the set-aside funding from actually being paid out to the adjudicated claimants. H.R. 1365 seeks to remedy these language deficiencies by making technical corrections to the statute. The language contained in H.R. 1365 was drafted in consultation with the U.S. Treasury and the U.S. Department of the Interior to ensure the intended outcome of the Loyalty Recognition Act is made whole. And at this time, Mr. Chairman, I would like to further enter into the record with unanimous consent a letter from Deputy Assistant Secretary Michael DeRoma from the U.S. Treasury, affirming basically that the language in 1365 would in fact remedy the structural deficiencies in the previous statute without any objections, Mr. Chairman. And lastly, Mr. Chairman, I would just like to ask my colleagues of the committee to support H.R. 1365 so that we may make whole the greatest generation, many of whom are sadly leaving us before seeing closure. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Nicolas, if there's is there any further discussion on the legislation?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Bishop.
Can I say very briefly that I approve of what you have done and what your predecessor had done? This is important work, and I thank you for bringing it up. I fully support this bill. Yield back.
Thank you. Are there any amendments to the legislation? Seeing none, the question now is on adopting the the bill and ordering favorably reported to the House. All those in favor of the, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, and this is not even a guess, the ayes have it, and the bill is ordered favorably reported. The motion to reconsider is laid on the table. We now will move to H.R. 1305.